Sports Pulse fans, welcome back. I am here with the CEO and commissioner of the XFL, Oliver Luck. How are you doing?
Mackenzie, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good. Now, this is the inaugural season coming up. How involved have you been? I know you used to work for the NCAA, so this is kind of all new for you, too.
So I've been involved literally in every detail in terms of the football part of what we're doing. I started about a year and a half ago working for Vince McMahon. He's our founder and owner of our league. And he asked me to do a number of things, one of which was to sort of reimagine and reinvent the game a little bit, right? To update it, to look at innovations, right? To see how we can play a fast-paced game, an exciting game, a high-scoring game, which is what fans wanted to see. So I've spent a good bit of time, along with many others, right? Not only people that are working for us, but there's a whole group of folks. I think of John Fox, former Super Bowl coach, or Jim Caldwell, Doug Flutie, guys along the way that really helped us. They would pop in for a day or two. We'd take their time and their advice. And so it's been a pretty big group of folks that have helped us as we've gotten to this point.
Yeah. And what's been your biggest goal as commissioner coming into this inaugural season?
The biggest goal is to create sort of a foundation where we can play good, fast-paced, up-tempo, crisp football, right? Yep. Football that people want to watch and players want to play and coaches want to coach. Football is our national sport. Mm-hmm. It's long surpassed, I think, baseball in terms of its popularity. Yep. And it's also become very important to people. It's a very important part of the social fabric, you know, particularly down south where, you know, football on a Saturday or Sunday is a big, big deal. So, you know, people take their football seriously. We realized we had a great opportunity to build this new league, mm-hmm. but only if it was real, down-to-earth football that folks could identify with. 11 on 11, four plays, the running, tackling, catching, all those fun things that we enjoy. And so that, you know, putting that all together and making sure that, you know, we could play well and play fast and play hard, getting guys like Bob Stoops to be a, you know, head coach, or June Jones or Mark Trestman. These are very successful coaches, getting great players, you know, whether it's Cardale Jones or Landry Jones or Jones brothers, you know, to talk about quarterbacks in particular. You know, those are all quality football people. So it's really the quality of the game has been our focus really since day one.
I was going to say, what's going to be the biggest difference between this XFL compared to the previous ones or even the AAF?
So there'll be really nothing in common with the XFL outside of the name, quite honestly. You know, we're focused on the football. We've spent a lot of time preparing for these games. We think we're buttoned up in all of those respects after our draft and mini camps and training camps. We've got great broadcast partners with Fox and ESPN that'll be showing these games on national television. All 43 of our games will be on national television. We've got, I think, a great group of coaches and players. Football's first, right? Football is foremost in the league, and that's really what we focused on. The game will be a fast-paced game. I think our most important innovation is the 25-second play clock. So in the NFL, it's 40 seconds. In the XFL, it'll be a 25-second play clock. We'll have
a lot quicker.
It's a lot quicker. We'll have a ball-spotting official whose only job is to spot the ball so that the teams can really play fast. Gotcha. So we want to play fast. We want to play up-tempo. It's almost, imagine you're watching, you know, a two-minute drill, you know, for the course of a full first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, into the fourth quarter. We think that's going to be fun. We want to have the same number of plays, more or less, as you get in a professional football game. It's about 170. Mm-hmm. But also kind of shrink that time a little bit and try to get those games done in under 3 hours.
Yeah. And with March Madness, baseball starting, give me an elevator pitch as to how spring football fits into that mix.
Well, I think spring football fits in very well because spring football is the most popular sport that we have in this country. Basketball, baseball, all great sports, but I think football is such a critical component in this country. And as you know, a lot of people are upset, right, because they're despondent. Yeah, after the traditional season ends, they want more football. So we believe we can provide more football at a high quality level, get folks really engaged, interested in that football. 10-game season, week 11 is a semifinals, week 12 the championship game. It's all done by April 26th, Sunday, which is the weekend of the NFL draft. So that's why I think we're really well poised to see this thing work.
And how supportive was your family and even Andrew with you taking on this new endeavor?
Andrew was very supportive. Obviously, he loves football, even though he's retired now and enjoying his first child and having a little bit of downtime. Yeah. He still loves the game. He's been somewhat of an unofficial advisor to me if I have questions about this or that. Yeah, I mean, he played long enough in the NFL and in college. My family's very supportive. They love to see me doing what what I like to do, which is build things, right? This is basically building something and building it, I think, for the long term. That's important as well.
Yeah, and I mean, going back to Andrew, with him retiring recently, I mean, what was your message to him? Like, what was that like? Did you know beforehand that he was going to retire? How'd that kind of go?
Well, you know, I was certainly aware that, you know, he was getting sort of worn down, if you will, by the constant cycle of injury and rehab and injury and rehab, particularly with his labrum, right?
Yeah.
Throwing shoulders, so that, you know, that matters, right? As a quarterback. And you know, we're close as a family, so I was aware of some of his frustrations. My advice to Andrew has been, and always will be, you know, do what you think is right. If you don't have that 100% enthusiasm and emotion for the game, then you shouldn't play. It's a tough game to play. And careers, for a lot number of reasons, are relatively short. And that's one of them. It's a very hard game to play. So he's fine. He's doing well. I think he'll continue to enjoy the game. Yeah. Who knows? He may get involved at some point.
That's
not necessarily as a player.
That's what I was about to ask.
Not necessarily as a player, but who knows? He might follow his old man's steps and get into sort of football administration.
Ooh, guys, look out. Now, I want to ask you, last question, are there any certain matchups you think are going to be ones that like are must-see or something that fans should really be excited about, certain matchups?
There's a couple of offensive coordinators in our league and head coaches that I can't wait to see them face each other. So you've got Hal Mumme, who's the architect of the air raid offense,
yes,
right?
Sir.
Hal Mumme was Mike Leach before there was Mike. Hal was Cliff Kingsbury before there was Cliff.
He's crazy. I met him before. I love him.
Hal's awesome.
He's awesome.
He's the offensive coordinator up in Dallas. So when he takes on L.A. and Norm Chow is every bit as gifted in terms of his creativity as Norm is. That's going to be as Hal is.
Yeah.
That's going to be fun. Throw in June Jones and his run and shoot offense. Yep. Everywhere June's gone. Houston Gamblers, Houston Oilers, Atlanta Falcons, College, Hawaii, SMU up in Canada where he won a Grey Cup. You know, everywhere he's been very creative. Mark Trestman, another great coach who won a couple of Grey Cups up in Canada, known for his creativity. Pep Hamilton, been an offensive coordinator at a number of NFL teams, as well as in college, most recently for Jim Harbaugh at Michigan. So these are guys that are very creative. And Kevin Gilbride up in New York, I feel bad about leaving anybody out because, you know, the red thread that sort of connects all these guys is their creativity. Jonathan Hayes in St. Louis, who was a great tight end in his day, played for the Chiefs, played for the Steelers. Jonathan's our head coach in St. Louis. Yep. He's got some really – Chuck Long, a great quarterback himself in the NFL, great Iowa quarterback. He's calling his plays. Chuck's very gifted at that. Yep. So there's just a lot of fun offensive stuff that I can't wait to see.
Yeah, and I forgot to ask you, are you guys going to have any relationship with the NFL at all? I know I didn't know if you guys were going
to
have –
So we're building this league to be a standalone league so that we have our own brand identity, et cetera, in our markets. There's no formal relationship with the NFL. Informally, there's probably, and I'm not exaggerating, 1,000 different touch points. You know, I used to work for the NFL. I've got a bunch of coaches who've been in the NFL as players, as coaches. A lot of our staff people have worked at the league office and at various clubs. So there's probably 1,000 touch points that we have informally with the NFL and have a great working relationship there. But formally, there is no relationship.
Gotcha. And remind me, what's the first opening day?
So opening day is the weekend after the Super Bowl.
Weekend
so,
after
you know,
Super
10
Bowl.
Days from now, February 8th.
Only 10 days.
February 8th and 9th, we're kicking off. And I'll be remiss if I don't say that one of the things very important to Vince is affordability. For $20, you can walk in and buy a ticket and sit in the lower bowl of CenturyLink Field in Seattle or Raymond James Stadium down in Tampa or MetLife even, right? So it's very affordable. Vince is really focused on making sure that a family of four can go watch a professional football game, enjoy all the hoopla, all the fun, all the excitement, you know, for less than $100. And that's kind of special.
It's huge. Are you going to have like t-shirts and everything for fans to get?
It'll be a great fan experience. It'll be family friendly. There'll be music. There'll be DJs. There'll be, you know, t-shirt tosses,
all those
things that you expect from a football game. Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, guys. Be sure to check out the first games in the XFL. It's inaugural season. Thank you again so much, Oliver Luck. I appreciate it. Sports Pulse, we will be right back with more. Don't go anywhere.